Okay, so I'm gonna do a seafood all together. I'm gonna steam fish and I'm gonna do some seafood boil. So that's land crab, it's like these are Jamaican crab, and these are some I think I bring these, all of these, the crab and the crayfish from Jamaica. So those, and over here I have shrimp, a box of shrimp. I have corn, pepper, thyme, and potato, and mussels, and plus I have some frankfurters. And over here I have my water, my salt, and I put my thyme and scallion night. But this is for the crab and the crayfish and the other stuff, and I'm gonna deal with differently. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna put in my seasoning and I'm gonna also add this into it also. So yeah. They don't spice it up and make everything nice and merry. You don't know, this is seafood boiled today on the Friday, yeah? So, pepper straw. Just add in the cock soup and then just stir everybody in. Yeah. I'm going to put the potato then in there. Just some potato there all the way down to the bottom. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to rinse off these. My crab and me. Crayfish, yeah, so that's it. So it's time for these to go into the hot water. Yep, well, they have a swim, you know that. Smell good. So let's take the fish in the know. I'm just taking another one, but that look a big, that big one. In but look a big one. I mean, I'm gonna do this one. Cut it in 3 pieces. This is just me and my husband, so I don't need to do a second one. So I don't think we have any visitors today. So that's it. Rinse it up and clean it up. Anything. And then let's move on to the other stuff, the shrimp and the mussel. Yeah. Yeah, so the crayfish them are turning color, change them color. See? And soon taste one of the claw them to see if I have enough salt in the water. Mm-hmm. And then I add more if I need it. So just it, chop one. So now I'm gonna put in me my frankfurters. As I say, the I'm not gonna use my egg today because I'm not really feeling for no egg in this, but that's it. Make everything go and simmer in it, now cover it up and make it go and do it thing. Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna put in the mussels them now. My pot. So I'll back when I put it in. I sit here, all in. Now I'm going to cover it up and make it steam. Yep. Okay, all I'm going to add to this is this is a little bit of salt and a little Maggi. You know? There. And that's about it. And right there is still going on. I'm not going to cover it coming on doing over, so I'm going to just leave it open and make it go on. So, don't know my seafood, so I'm going to have like the shrimp and the fish. So right now I'm gonna season the fish literally. So I'll show you what I'm gonna use for the fish. Okay, first off, this is the fish, and I have a ginger there, and over here I have the fish seasoning and complete, and black pepper and Maggi with ginger, which I'm gonna grate it, the garlic and the ginger. That's over there. Sorry, this is garlic and this is the ginger right here. And look a piece. Isn't it? I mean, I want the garlic to overpower the steamed fish. And right here, I have butter. Some butter and all of that I will go into this steamed fish. Yeah? You don't know? And piece of pepper. I forgot to take out the pepper too. Yeah. So, when I done throw and grate everything, I come back and show you how it look. Alright? I'm going to use the salt because I'm seasoned over there. So, yeah, have salt. So, I'm going to use none right now. unless my taste and meat required a little more something like it, then I put it. For right now, I them the over the side with some shrimp. After this, then I have the shrimp left. And then you done know, the girl done. Yeah. So, I grated some of the garlic already. I did the ginger. It's right there. And I'm going to grate like 3 more. As I have more on here. Which I could put all of it in there. Because in fish I like ginger. Garlic. So, I'm going to grate some more. And then I'll come back and show you what's popping. Okay, so... So it starts being its own juice. And it's juice all the way down in there. Yeah. These are the mussels, nice and juicy. See? Nice juice down in there. And I just turn it from low. Actually medium. Not low. Medium on. I just wind it in there. You know? Yeah. And stir. And look like some black cockroach though. Yeah. So we're gonna have cockroach for dinner. Yo. I'm joking. These are mussels. So I'm gonna close it down. No water. I put just a little bit, but I don't need no more water because it has enough juice. I'll have to just stir it to keep it. Okay, and these are actually almost done, you don't know. Now that go potato them down on the bottom. So yeah. See the sausage them start float there. So right here we keep, we are gonna do a little sprinkles. Alright, and I'm thinking, I'm changing my mind, I'm gonna rinse off some of the shrimp and add it to the fish. So I'm gonna have to keep on that change. I do different something. So now I'm gonna put on the black pepper and thing. So I'm gonna just cook the steam the fish on there. The fish and the shrimp together. Only thing I gotta do different is this. Put it in, boil it in some different sauce. Butter, a little water, and pepper. I gotta put the corn in. So this is the fish seasoning, by the way. So before me rub up this, I gotta get wash off some of the shrimp. I will be back show you how I'm doing this thing. Now I gotta mash up this thing with my butter. You get me? Yeah, man. So I'm sink yourself, so I'm clean up that. I don't know where I go. Alright, see. Oh, sorry. I'm just in these. This is the shrimp, which I like to cause fun out of it. I'm ready to mix with the fish. So. Yeah. But I think this is how we do. Put it on no more. Yeah, that's it though. No more fish shrimp. Then mix, and then mix it up back then around there. We still have quite a few left in this. So. Done now. That done with. So, where yeah, so. Is the fish shrimp on there. And then the seasoning top of this. So, never do that, and then we get back to it, alright? Okay, so. Me season everybody up now. Rub up everybody. No time for me get my pot going on the stove so I can done this thing. Yeah. I'm going to add one of the cockroach because I still want to put more flavor. So this one is cockroach spicy chicken mix, soup mix. So I add another one to it. So it's kind of thick and a little more salt in it. Yeah. And if you turn on the butter before I put in the butter. Alright, so here goes. I'm gonna sniff the stir it some more. I'll be back to show you. Alright, so we are going with the fish now. I totally forgot to put on, but I have hot water in the pipe. Turn on there. I forget some hot water and I take it. So this after I go down, some more and melt, I add some hot water to it and just deal with it. Put my fish in there because as I say, I steam fish me, I do. So, you may make more to melt and then I put some hot water in. Okay, so this are the, I'll put some, look about 2 more garlic in here, cut up 2 more garlic, plus the scallion. And I already have time over there, so I'm gonna get some hot water put in this. because I thought this would hot already. Maybe try to turn on the tickle, but it's not. So that's me. My butter and my garlic. You don't know shrimp and so. I love garlic too, so it's a steam fish business this, so I like a lot of garlic in it, and you know steam fish and I use no vinegar period. Steam fish is just strictly butter. Oh, me do it actually. Everybody do it for them one different. Me put make garlic and my butter and my scallion and thyme and plus my grated some garlic on the fish and a piece of ginger. You get me? So that's the whole purpose. That's how I do it, I should say. Now I'm gonna get some, may have some hot water in the pot, but I doubt it go really hot like the one pan the stove, so I don't know. I'll be back when I put in some water in here. Okay, so I'm gonna add the water in. Maybe another half. Put my water. Let me turn up there. Because I'm going to put the shrimp in, I'm going to need to come out of water. And make it go and boil up some more, cover it, make it go and boil up, and then, yeah. Oh, wrong cover. Oh, my bad. Hold on. So, the muscle then finished. Everybody opened up very well. And, if I put it on low, anything. So, the muscle them done. I never bother putting a sock, I'm going to taste one of them, and The sauce of the night, not really fresh, so I just leave it as it is. And this soon can turn off a little. Actually, I'm going to drop on it, pepper in the butt. I don't want my husband kind of afraid of pepper. So I'm not going to bother drop no more pepper in it. I'm just going to make it stay as it is. Is it that actually done, but the potato, I'm going to test the potato them yet. So, I don't know, after me done the test the potato, I let you know when I done this seafood boil here. Okay, man, so me catch you back in the next 2 minutes time. So over here, so I got to do the corn, so I put a little salt, piece of pepper and butter in the, for the corn. So the corn in there, I'm going to cover it up and make that go and cook while I got to the fish right now. Okay, so I'm gonna drop in my fish them right now. Yeah. And he claims that I just have to do 2 fish, so I end up I gotta do all of them. I guess tomorrow I can eat some with some green banana. So I'm gonna have to cook tomorrow. Alright, so and then mature the shrimp and plant. So put them in there, and then you don't know the chef said this. And for everybody, I'm mingling the I mean, if you want, you could also cook the shrimp different, but I'm like not in the mood. But everything can steam because at the end of the day, this is like I go the same route with the shrimp, garlic, butter, local water, and boil them night because that's just a seafood. And oh yeah, I need a piece of pepper in this too. So that's how we are going with this. Literally, it smells so good already. I'm gonna add in the pepper yet. I'm gonna cover it down and make it go and steam. I get the piece of pepper and add to it. Okay, so this is the fish and the crayfish, the shrimp. I literally totally forgot I'm videoing to like talking to myself. Anyway, the shrimp that I wanted them thing and the fish. So make it one steam and thing. Let me taste it to see if I want more. I'm not ready to taste it yet. Make it one bubbling and put on a little bit of gravy. And then I taste it, because sometimes when I taste it too early, it's too fresh, and then I think it needs more salt or anything else, and it happens when it go down to gravy, it's very, so this actually done, right? And just have a cover it up to I'm ready to serve and show on later. Yeah. So right over here, so we have the corn, a grinding thing, and the mussel finish. Yeah, nicely done. And over here we have our crab and crayfish and potatoes and frankfurter. The noigle tastes real good. And so forth. Yeah man. I still like it. Yeah. Everybody don't like it. Okay, so this is the finishing touch for the crayfish and the shrimp and the fish. So maybe if you guys have put the pepper in this, and I just put it in there and turn it down for low and left it. But everything literally done. The corn over here is done, so I just have to turn it down low, keep it warm to murder the fish here. Everything literally done.